this full moon has to be by far the most beautiful and the most intense. Listen, this full moon is about breaking karmic cycles as back as 2008. On top of that, you need to master letting go and seeing the patterns that are causing you to not get things that you want in your life. Number three, you also need to be at a space of accepting the role you also play in your own suffering. Number four, you need to be able and open to accept the new energies that this full moon is doing, and you need to set your intentions, your goals, meditate. Jani chom, Jani. Jani, Jani Jako. Welcome, my beautiful family. Togoza Stogo, Lozi Hands Worldwide. I am Mpho Wabadimu, the advocate of Idlozi, Ugogo Unkomiyasaba. All right, before we get into this video, I went for my braces fitting a couple of days ago. So I've been on liquid diet, but I haven't been to my braces appointment in like forever because I haven't been finding time. And it is what it is. But all I could tell is that my doctor is not saying anything to me. She's not even saying, Mpho, you are halfway, Mpho, you're doing well. She's just saying to me, you're delaying yourself. And she just invoiced me my next a procedure that I need to do, which is about 35K. So because I pay my procedures and things cash, so all I can say is that braces are expensive, guys. The monthly visits. Okay, I don't go for the monthlies. I go when I can, but ngokomthetho, I need to literally go every 2-3 weeks or 4 weeks, you know, if I'm late, 5 weeks. But mina, sometimes I stay two months and so braces are costly. If you are gonna invest in braces, do that. I heard someone was saying that there's this lady, actually I didn't hear someone, there's this lady I saw here on YouTube. She's talking about veneers, because initially I wanted to get veneers and my doctor was like, no, you got beautiful teeth, you got a beautiful smile, let us first transform you, and then if you don't like what you see, then we can go into the veneers department. But until I bumped into this lady here on YouTube, she's got veneers on, beautiful, amazing, but what she said changed my whole perspective of seeing the veneers. She said veneers cause you to have a stinky breath, especially if they were not inserted properly. And remember, they are forever and they also need maintenance. So if you go to someone, because she said she got hers in Turkey, if you go to someone that puts in the veneers and there's a small gap, as she did, she does explain these terms, guys, same time. So I'm thinking, so this is not something I've heard first. For the first time, I've always heard kuthi kunabangani bamke abazwana nababhuti bama veneers laba basima bahleka ngathi mbila bakhona abanawo ama veneers and bayangitshela mina ukuthi hayi chomi ugrothers ngathi une problem your breath. So it's not even their problem, it's the veneers. So it's like, as much as also us brace people, we need to brush 3 times a day, it's more work with the veneers, like kuningi. That's why sometimes you know what, I'll just move with my teeth. I'll insert what I need to insert and see what I abridge, whatever it is that I need to. But all I wanted to tell you basically is that my teeth are going through the most. So don't mind me if I'm talking funny. I haven't bought my waxes. So the wires, the new wires, have actually dug into my mouth inside, you know. So especially the bottom part, like I'm going through the most. So I'm trying to, I don't know, but I'm gonna go to the shops tomorrow and try and get something and try and get a wax. But anyway, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Gosh, why did my hands go like that? Hold up. Okay. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. I am Paul Wabadimu. No ways. Okay, now we're doing it. Welcome back to, I am Mpho Wabadimu, the advocate of Idlozi, Ugogo, Unkomo Yahlaba, Isangoma, Inkosazana, Unobuhle, and once again, I welcome you to another YouTube video. I don't know if I should call this a story time or a sit down, whatever it is, but we'll see the direction of the conversation where it's going, because I want us to talk about everything that's going on now. I want us to talk about a lot. So allow me in your space for these couple of minutes, grab yourself something to drink, and like this video, leave your comments down below, share if you have to, subscribe if you haven't. I don't know what I'm forgetting. Anything else? Tenya mumonya. Tenya. Yeah. Okay. So first of all, I don't know about you, but I have been, first of all, 2024 is one of the most hectic years in my spiritual existence. No lies. We've been facing full moons back to back. We've been getting retrogrades back to back. It's like when you're trying to recover, there's always something happening. And from where we stand, November, December, honestly. So we're still going to go through a lot. But outside of that, in the spiritual cycle or the African cycle, whatever it is, yeah. August is like the December. So basically, I'm the December baby in the spirit or in the African spiritual, however you choose to look at it. But this is how I've been living my life, Mina. I could see every time, every August, I slaughter, right? I slaughter. Every August, I slaughter something. So the trick with slaughtering something, it is not even about you. Because people do this and they think they are doing something right. Remember, masihlaba sisuke sihlabela okuzayo sibonga okuzayo. We are practicing the laws of the universe, and gratitude is one of the most heaviest. My lips are very dry, pardon me. Let me put some vitamin C first. So guys, have you ever heard of people saying ukuthi mina ngithola umsebenzi and then ngayenza ngithola umsebenzi bese ngayenza umsebenzi omadlozi ngathi ngiyabonga and no, bese umsebenzi lapho waphela. Yes, that is very common, because you're telling your ancestors that they've done enough for you. You need to be able to test your power and tell amadlozi akho ukuthi, you know what, I want more, give me more. Okay, because where you are right now, you are living in an answered prayer. You are living in an answered prayer where you are right now. So le oyiphila manje yile obuyicela uyibonga emsamo. So practically uma uzohlaba wenza umsebenzi manje, you are being grateful for what is coming. You understand? So don't make a mistake of saying uyimsamo and be like ngiyabonga umsebenzi, ngiyabonga in. You ask for that. That's why it's in your life. That's why it's in your space. That's why amadlozi akho made it happen, that it's there, because you asked for it. You said to your dlozis, I want a job. I want a child. I want a wife. I want this. I want a house. I want a car. And they're giving you that. You know, that's how I tell you, mhlawumbe uqeda ukuthenga imoto and then wenza ama accident. You are stuck in the spiritual realm. You are stuck in a limbo. So as much as I say this all the time, ukwenza umsebenzi gogo mkhulu, it doesn't take you a lot of money. 500 rand, ungathenga inkukhu zakho zithu, wenze ukhamba lwakho, wenze papa, wenze ukhabishi wakho, umema abangani bakho, that's if uyabamema, and then nihlale nidle and not what kuphele. But in the intent, or rather the intention behind, is more important than you buying a big cow, especially if you are not doing it from your heart. Yabona umsebenzi mawenzela abantu, it always comes back to biting the ass. Who are you showing off to? You're supposed to be grateful, humble yourself. That is why 2 weeks before uzoyenza umsebenzi, or a week before, you literally are in that stage of, you know, mourning, that stage of looking back and be like, yazi idlozi lingenzelile, idlozi lingiphilele. Now I'm looking forward to the next chapter. So you do your things, wenza umsebenzi wakho. Sometimes kunomuntu ozoyenza umsebenzi ngenkomo, bese umunye ayenze ngeenkukhu, but lo wenkukhu into zakhe zikhanya kudlula lo wenkomo. It is the intent behind it. So before you are too quick to show off emsam, because the more ukhula ngidlozi noma ukhula ngokwenza, you are showing amadlozi akho nawe ukuthi ayakusebenzela, anamandla, or whatever the case might be. So more lokhu khula eventually uzofaka ilontoza imbuzi, ufake imbuzi neinkukhu, ufake in you know, particularly, I'm so sorry guys. Mina ke ngacabana neinkukhu kudala, ngiyayithanda kodwa ngingayithandisisi. So most of the case mina mangenza umsebenzi, it's more or less a chick goat and sheep, or goat and chicken ngaleso sikhathi, and then inkomo kuzoba nesizathu sayo. Like ngiyabona for my 5 years I did a cow, and now for my 10 years I'm gonna also do a cow. You understand? There's a reason. You don't just slaughter a cow, you understand? Or mhlampe khona umuntu oshadayo, whatever the case might be. So my point to you is that ungakhohlwa ukubonga. We say this a lot of times, see izangoma, but it's not even about you ukubonga where you come from. It's about being grateful for what's coming. Because if what's coming, like guys, I don't know if I'm talking to somebody, when you set your affirmations or you meditate, you say thank you, thank you, thank you to the universe, because you see it already being there. You are grateful, and then we move to the next thing, set it and forget it. So move smart, move with these things, and know what's happening to you. So as I was saying, that around this time, most of you dozy hands are going to be feeling very spiritually fatigued and tired and less productive. Abanye endumbeni shemnizoba a wall. Abanye benu niselifini. Amadlozi nani phi freedom. Isebenziseni. But before ngizothi isebenziseni, zangoma, ntana bedlozi, do you know how dangerous the winter time is? Winter time is very dangerous for us losing hands, because we vibrate at our highest. And when we vibrate at our highest, our sexual energy is intense. At this time, you are able to meet someone and be infatuated and think you just met the love of your life. Can't you know? It's you attract what you are. So at the time when you're vibrating so high and your sexual energy is so intense, you run at a greater risk of falling pregnant. Of being heartbroken, of being distracted spiritually. Of going through a lot of things, because I don't want to lie to you, as much as winter is a perfect time to do things, witchcraft, healing, and all those other things, it's also a crazy time for the losing hand. Uzomangala ufune isex ngendlela ungayiunderstand, and I'm here to tell you guti, it is normal, because around this time kufika abadlozi amanikazi bendawo abantu basemanzini. And when that part of yourself has been activated, you will feel the need to want, like, look at this. Sometimes you might be fasting and thinking you need to go to the river. As soon as you come to the river, mawoya emanzini, you are horny as fuck. I don't want to lie to you. Sex plays a major role when it comes to spiritual things. Ungadidegi, do not be confused. Sex plays a major role in the things of the spirit. And that is why us as losing hands, we are always being protected by amadlozi wethu. Because if we were to move, like, I'm loosely using the word how umdawu, or whatever it is you want, you choose to call it. Mina ngibabiza ukuthi abantu basemanzini, because they are not some dirty people wearing idumane. they are the fanciest of your ancestral tree. Go back to my old videos where I was explaining Umdao, Umguni, and all these other things. You'll get to understand what I'm talking about. They are the fanciest in your spiritual tree. They are the ones that give you beauty. They are the ones that give you bagwenza uthande izinto ube muhle uthande into ezisofti ube ilwe umuntu nje. You understand? They are the ones that give you money, that take care of you financially. They are your blessers, those ones. They are the ones that they are the ones, they are the, and they love sex. People don't talk about this enough. I'm gonna tell you this, Mina. They love sex, and most of you as Lozi Hans, majority around this time, winter, you will know what kind of people you work with. So unfortunately, get as cooling or fana because now I'm corner and kulanga jengo muni muntu mtasina ngakeda part until after indlela yam ngabe singhlangana nabo labantu laba. I want to describe you how the first encounter with those people was, but I don't want to go into detail, but all I can tell you is they are gorgeous people. Like, they are gorgeous. If you think sibahle, you don't know anything. If you think my skin looks good, this is nothing. They look beautiful and they love nice things. Majuals, chelete, bagatadilo tsentlefela. And that's the same thing, ehamba now. They are not the ones of abuzukambisa ngenyawo vele umkenke, no. You levels, sana. Levels. So they are the, like, the north of your ancestors, the bougie side of your ancestors. So when it comes to winter like this, it is very dangerous for you because uzomitha sangoma. Uzomitha ngenxa yebhonyobhonyo, ibhontshisi lizokufaka emasimbeni. Uzothi thina sama sesithweka laphaya emigidini wena ube ushushuzela ngenxa yokuthi you allowed your vibrations to control you. If they are controlling you, the lust inside of you will just be heavy. Allow, but take precautionary measures. Mina, I was telling my friend the other day, kuthi inkinga yabantwana bedlozi bayathanda ukuzenza ngathi baphila ku bubble and they are Mary Magdalene's cousins and they are Jesus's ex-girlfriend. And bona, they are just sitting there. What we understand, you need to keep purity, Mara. We know you. When your doses have given you the visas, you operate levels. Remember, sex ihamba nama vibration. Inyoka yakho mayifuna umuntu wendoda or mayifuna ukuthi exchange igazi nomuntu li izoyenza iplan and uzodliwa noma wena uzomudla umuntu. And it's not because mele uhambe uyodliwa, kunegazi omele ulikhiphe. Angisho nginichaselile if mhlawumbe niyibukelile leya video leya engiyenzile recently. Can I just fix lighting here? No chef loyana nganichazela ukuthi lento esikuyo iyafana nokuthi uthwele, just ukuthi angisho asa abantu abazazi ithwalo.
First we need to look at isangoma in a broader context. Uma ubheka isangoma umuntu othwele ngedlozi, and isithwalo nesithwalo esiba khona sinemithetho yakhona. Kunemithetho eba between umuntu nedlozi lakhe, and we never know of them because it's between you and your ancestors. But there's certain sacrifices and things you can and cannot do. So now, as isangoma, you want to date, you want to have a relationship, you want to get married, but the healer in you will always attract people in your life. Your energy generally will always bring people that need from your healing pot because you're born healer. So whether you want to be in a relationship or not, everyone that crosses your path is there for a reason. There's a seed that you need to plant in their lives. There's a seed that you need to harvest in their lives. And it's got nothing to do with you, but what you are putting in that person. So the aspect of dating as a spiritually gifted child is a challenge. The 2Ks will say siyagoa, enevele siyagoa, because we are encountering people that do not know how to move with us. Dating isangoma or a spiritual person, it means
kunabantu abazile kuma DM am hayi mpho mina ngithwelanga ngisangoma mara why mina ngingayazi lento le ngathi my love asifanani. We can all wear era, but we are not from the same. You understand? You might have bought yours at Mall of Africa. I mean, I bought mine at Sentin City. It does not mean that it is the same. You understand? So I was telling people that ukuthi isithalo sakho awusazi ukuthi sikuzokufunani wena. Imimoya ibalulekile. But on top of that, kuba nabogobelo abasile abazokutshela ukuthi umndawo wakho kuza kwenzela amagona mele alale nawe. Loyo muntu loyo ukhuluma amasimba. Akekho umuntu omele akuthize ngendlozi mele alale nawe. Inyoka yakho ofa ngithi your snake, it is the one that is going to choose who you need to sleep with. That phase comes and goes. That is something that is not spoken about. That is why uthola abantu abathwele bayalala nabantu. It is not because bayathanda bashinto zabe bantwini. You understand? You need to release. So anyeke ungitshela ukuthi isangoma wena unyaka wonke awudunus uzohlanya. Because you need ungayikhiphi energy yakho ukhiphe meditate ufuthi, but you need that release ukuthi kumele kube ne exchange of blood or whatever the case of be. So that's why it's life is very spiritual. Life is very spiritual. Like, it is so fucking deep. I don't know how to explain it to you. And people like to be narrow-minded and think ukuthi it is one-sided. It is a lot of things. Yes, bayahlonisha labantu laba, but ngikhuluma ngani nina abaphathi abanikazi bezinto. You know what I'm talking about. So let's not live like we're in a bubble. We are human. We do have sex. It's just guti tina. When we are engaging in sex, there's always an intent behind it. It is not just G. Because there comes a time when you want sex. And then there also comes a time when you like, so lose the interest. Uzibuze ukuthi kanjani? Because we have to umnikazi esikhwama. Atsi, close. So close. Close. This everything is energy, guys. This world we live in is an energy warp, and ama energy wento oyifunayo mawangakuvumanga anye kuyithole. Everywhere lento oyifunayo, there are energies of wealth, there are energies of success, there are energies of sangoma gifts, there are energies of powerful people, there are energies of everything. And if ama energies lawo angakuvumanga angakuxomanga uzofutha mtase ngeyiwasho ezipink, uzofutha mtase uzube pink, uzube ishishiboya. But ama energies ma angakuxomanga, you are lost. So everything is about energy. We need to evolve to a point whereby we teach people how to tap into the energies. Nokuthi umuntu ayenze into embi usuka vunywe ilawa ama energies of those dark energies ukuthi when you'll be able to kill, you'll be able to do this. So you don't find yourself in something idlozi lakho lingakufunanga lapho noma ini. I always say into mayingamelanga yenzeke idlozi make sure ukuthi awuyi lapho. Uzogula, uzozibheka esipilini ubone ngathi uyindoda, kuzovela izinto ezifani. But idlozi mali kufunile lapho melenze away ukuthi ufike lapho. You must know good it you were wanted there. Either your snake made you go there, and there's a reason. There's a season, the reason, a lesson, a blessing, a curse, whatever. But when you are supposed to go through something, in your iPhone in Lulap, ozon Lulap. We are almost at the end of the year. Minunyagawam, no munyagawe tsunabanya ba pilanjingam, ukalango September. And next month, December. So, calendar size squash. right now I'm not productive. I don't want to lie because I feel that energy of nami fuze ngi cleanse nami fuze ngenzeni because there's just been a lot of energy. So ngizo yenza lokho kufuze ngiyenze ngisamile ngiye my cave ngithamile ngenzeni. So there's just a lot of things I need to do on my end. But in things on tshela yona, life is spiritual. Life is energy. Don't be bored in your gift. Within the gift, there is fun. There is fun. I don't want to lie to you. But mali vali lilos, kuthi ivisa yakhiphelile askisi nana. So make the most of it. Whatever that means. Make the most of it. Make the most of it. So don't ever look at your life and feel like, yeah, mina, why, mina, no. So umuntu even know umsiza, umncengisa ama energies, uyancuncusa. That is why there's a God of money. There's a God of this. There's a God of that. There's a God of this. And that is why you need to spill blood. Because these are gods. You need to ncenga. Everything is energy. So I cannot take you to the river and say, you're going to get a million. Or njanjan. You must nkuncusa the gods. And particularly anything related to the soft life, you must go to the water. And there are rituals, certain rituals you need to do over a period of time. Ulokuba consistent. Angisho you uncenga this person, this god of whatever it is. Like, I'm talking deep things with you guys, but lo onendlebe uzongizwa. So move into this new year knowing that le oyifunayo uyoyisebenzela. Uzoyisebenzela. It's an eye for an eye and a success for a success and a blood for your blood. That is it. Like, that's how life is. That's how life is so spiritual. It's so beautiful. It's just unfortunate. Gutsi, we as black people look at everything and feel the need to look down at it. These pastors taking your power away, but they go to the same gods to ask for you guys. There's a god of deceivement. There's a ayikintenganama gatekeeper wakhona. Meludile nomnikazi wayo so one-on-one. Ukuthi, what do you want? And then he tells you that if you want this, you should do this. So know where you stand. Because there's also a very thin line between light and dark. That's how crazy the spiritual world is. There's a very thin line. So don't find yourself in a hole. There's a god, goddess of beauty. There's a goddess of beauty. You talk to her. I'm saying a lot, but I'm not saying a lot. Because I'm trying to say to you that life is not black and white. There's a lot of things that happen. There's a certain time, there's a certain god that arrives at a certain a province every year in this country, and certain people around that time, they go down there to that god because they know they are busy doing rituals, they are meeting at secret places. I know. So it's just a lot of things. Life is one big ritual, but also as a sangoma, you need to know how far your losies are willing to go. They go the length. That's why in case ngisho ngithi test your power as a losie child. Don't be boring. Test your power. Test your power. Use this full moon energy. Write down your affirmations. Test your power. Test your losies. Test your snake. Snake is a power. Snake is a symbol of power. If I could, I'd be having snake tattoos everywhere on my body. Because I've seen the power of that. It is who we are as a people. So just because my God is not white, my God has heads, mina. My God is not white, sitting, you know, with a robe somewhere in the sky. No. Just like Mozo Tolingani. Allows ukuthi ingane ibe khona. That is why umukhiphisiso, you need to cleanse uchithe igazi umehlisa umoya uxolise because uyo otha sizalaneni sibe baningi sande kuphilwe fuyani philani umhlaba mawuchubekile phambili. So when you chitha igazi phansi because you keep isis, it's blood for blood. Umuntu uyashona, there's a god of death. Chitha igazi. Guys, nina zonikahlela one by one sona so. But amongst all of these things, I feel so happy. If you're watching this video and you're feeling so depressed and you're feeling like, what the fuck is going on with me? You are not alone. This full moon is going to show you a lot of things. If you got into an argument, if you fought with somebody, whatever the case might be. But karmic patterns are deep, gogo. Kunento ezayo empilweni yakho ehlezi yenzeka every year or every situation. In my case, it's always been relationships. I feel personally, yes, as Lozi kids, we struggle with relationships. But for me, I'm walking down all relationships that I've been in. And I'm realizing there's a common pattern. And there's also, I blame myself also, Uguti. This is like different situations, but in same areas, you understand? So what do I do now? I sat down with myself. I'm like, Mpo, level up. You know, level up from, you've seen what being nice has done for you. You've seen what dating out of pity, you know, that pity relationship. And sometimes we stay for long periods thinking we are undateable. And anything that you find, you end up taking and thinking it is good for you, even though something is not good for you, you know. And I realized that I have overlooked a lot of things in people because I see the potential in them. And sometimes I stay because of what my ancestors want me to do at that time. But it is not enough for me, you know. And I've had to go down to my journal, to my universe journal, and be like, this is the type of men I want in my life. You know, because I can't say, mhlampe tomorrow I'm going to get married or meet my soulmate. But these are the type of men I want in my life. These are the type of friends I want in my life. These are the type of things I want in my life. And remodel myself. So that's what this full moon has had to do for me. I have had to go back and remodel and forgive myself and forgive everything that happened to me. You know, and also not having boundaries. I am the nicest person. Like, I'm very sweet and too sweet, Nihols. So I've had to realize that boundaries and leveling up is not just about your appearance, but about your energy sink, but about things that you want. Am I willing to be with a guy or Pfagi X or Gobisi X? No. I spent close to like 10-15k on perfumes. Why am I gonna settle for that? Level up, my guy. Let's see, you understand? Am I willing to be with a guy ogqoke ikawusi elidabukile osangitshela ukuthi uya dreama one day? I don't have time for that right now. I'm building myself up. So if when you're still Vuyo as a big dreamer, uzongibambezela because we're not talking the same thing. Am I willing to date a guy who does not want to live life, who does not want to, you know, who's stuck abe uthandi izinto? No, I'm not. Because I love things and things love me. You know what I mean? So this full moon, don't look at it negatively. But kabanga, it goes back as 2008. I was in grade 8 in 2008. And then gabune singe sihlama ngangizwana naso. Go 2008. It's a story for another day, but that was, imagine, I was in grade 8, I was dating this guy, and why am dalagim, but a seal in it. You understand? So am I gonna stay in, you understand? So that's how Ngisha Giti. This full moon is taking us back to things that we have lived, and they come back and revisit us in our life because we haven't fully healed from that. I've been living on antidepressants for the longest time, and I've been off the antidepressants ever since I found out that I'm pregnant. I made that decision for myself. This is my antidepressant now. This is my antidepressant, and doing things that nurture my spirit and nurture my soul. You know what I mean? So choose yourself in everything. I'm about to be 30. I'm so excited. I've got like less than 20 days to be 30. And I'm more excited about the new chapter I'm going into. My 20s were a lot. My lighting is failing me. I don't like... Okay, there's... Okay. My 20s. Zingkhulisile, ngabona ukuthi ngumuntu onjani. My weaknesses became my strengths. You understand? I manje sengusisi manje. Ngusisi. Even nasekhaya sengilomuntu lona umuntu makashonile isidumba siphuma ingakafiki bayambiza uphumpho umpho azaze umvala amehlo uyabona makuye ma graveyard yimi lomuntu lona uyangandastand ohamba phambili umntwana makawisile yimi lomuntu lobuzayo sigubhela kuphi inkaba uyangandastand sengikhulile manje guys angiseseyilela tshitshi lelana ngiyitshitshi because manje ngingena kuma 30s wami and I'm so excited about this chapter that it's bringing. It's my birthday on the 9th of August, but it's a rebirth for me because I'm stepping into a new chapter. 30. So I'm so excited. That's why I'm saying like this full moon came at a perfect time for me because it's enough validation that baby girl, you're on the right track. Like I'm so excited. I don't want to lie to you. I go to bed excited every day because I meditate before I go to bed, and the things I'm meditating in is wild as fuck, but I'm happy. I have so much peace in my life. I'm so happy. So 30 is about to be amazing. You know, my 20s were building me up for my 30s. And if you're watching this videos and you feel like Gogo, you still have another chance. Every birthday is another chance for you to work towards the things that you want. There is no timeline. We all thought by 26 we are going to be married with our kids. Ganti 26, that is where the mgoa is. You know what I mean? We did not know those things. So now you know better. Don't feel pressured. Uguti ye minas banbani. But life begins at 40. So you're still gonna kiss frogs, you're still gonna make mistakes, you're still gonna give up on twena. Skaboy chapeleta, wa chatella, wa unyako tareke stressi, unyako ba perfect. But what about perfect about lasting well for thing? But romantical, go my beatling. They are there committing suicide, taking their lives because they want to be perfect. There is no door of perfection, Lime Shabin. If you want perfect things, go do them in the science class. Be a scientist. Be Jesus is a what, but there is no perfection. So look at yourself in the mirror and love what you see, your imperfections, your flaws, everything else that you see. Everything, love and embrace, because the minute you start loving you and being grateful for everything, you start attracting new things. Uba muhle ungagezanga. Not because of umuhle, because of your skincare routine. No, that is a cherry on top. But you genuinely become beautiful because of how much value you put on yourself. So that is my message for you. I just wanted to take in and touch base and tell you that I'm still alive. I'm still kicking. To those that have been seeking me in terms of consultation and all of that, I'm really sorry guys, I've taken some time off. I haven't been well, I don't want to lie. I've just not been well. So I'm gonna be back at work in August, so anything around now I'm just gonna finish people off that I haven't seen. So if I haven't seen you particularly, I have not been taking virtual consultations a lot. I've been taking people that are coming to see me, but virtual consultation I just was like, let me just breathe, you know. So another person will not understand and say, post being bougie, post being that. But I can't pour into you if my cup is empty. And I can't come here and say, yay, I'm depressed. kyagoa hey every 5 minutes. No, but as a spiritual person, you'll understand that timing is everything, and if right now it's not meant to happen, eventually it is happen. It will happen when our paths are meant to cross. And to those also that have been saying, Gogo, sicela ukuzothwasa, guys, I mean, I don't know where have you seen what you are doing? I don't know where have you seen what you are doing. People that are gonna come and twasa are gonna be sent by their losses, and I will know because my losses will tell me. You don't need to shock me and come and tell me that you want to twasa, because I'm not gonna make you a sangoma. I'm gonna turn you into a spiritual bumblebee. You know what I mean? You're gonna be a bumblebee, spiritual bumblebee, because ngisitshelile nami ngathi yazini ubungoma buxhaphakile. Ubungoma abusena dignity, abusena respect. Bogogo, if you're gonna send kids my way, don't send abantwana that just want to be izangoma. Send people that wanna impact people's life and change the world, that are ready to hear the truth and see the things of the spirit with their third eye and not flinch. I want those type of people. Don't come here and tell me ukuthi ufuna ukuzongidela. I can watch people getting. I watch, you know, people from other countries, bagida kanjani and all of that. Don't tell me. Don't tell me ukuthi uzeli kuzongirasela. No, you're going to lose your vocal cords. Come here and tell me, listen, Gogo, I'm ready. And I'll take you. I'll take you high. Get close. But for now, the work, the wars of the spirit and the work is always around this time of the year, you know. So don't lose hope, don't lose faith. And if you're feeling discouraged in your spirituality, whatever, do not be afraid to take a break. So very soon I'm gonna be having a retreat. I'm so excited for that. I am super excited for that. So I will share details with that, but I'm not going to be taking a lot of people with me. So it's going to be something that's going to be happening September, October. I just need to confirm dates. And yeah, those are the things that I want to do. You see, I'm a bougie hun. I want to do retreats. I want to do, you know, master classes. I want to do sit and sips, sip and talk, all those things. That's just me, the direction of healing I want to take. And Umbeni, I've just, you know, it is what it is, but I've evolved. I'm evolving as a person. I don't want to lie to you, you know. And yeah, so it's Women's Month. We are about to celebrate ourselves. So let us do best. So enjoy this weekend, enjoy your week. Don't go through it angry and sad. Go through it very happy to go through it. So I was thinking I want us to do a Q&A. Lana, ask me anything. So I will put questions. I'll put a poster and put, so you can put your questions down. And then I'll also put something on my broadcast channel on Instagram. Then I'll come back and we do the Q&A. So yeah, just something fun, interesting, you know. I don't want the channel to be boring, and I see that you guys appreciate the vlogs. So the people that say, "Hi, I prefer them poor." That was, I'm still teaching. Literally, I just taught you a lot. You know, it's just that we have to adapt to change. I'm also a different person from the first video till what is sitting here. A very different people, my sister. We have elevated. We have grown. We have succeeded. So it's just a lot of things. So. you call police for the matter. You call police for the matter and you deal with everything. I don't collusion man to man. So we will evolve and as cool and sonke. So ngiyamthanda guys. Ninakekeleni amadluzi wenu. Nidliseni inyoka zenu. Ningamithi kodwa zango mandini. Ningamithi ngoba namitha. Oh, nice summer. Sifuna ukufree from amathanga manje. Sifuna ukufree from amadolo. Madolo wasephehlweni wasa sifuna ukufrifa amadolo, sifuna ukuqebezela. Wena usafuna ukuqhubisa isinono. Prega if you feel good, because yabona ozayo manje uyoyifihla angaveli, uyovela sekukudala, because angisho umntana walabantu labaya. So good trick. So let me love and leave you beautiful people. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel.
like this video if you haven't. Comment down below anything. How the full moon has been treating you. What you think of this message. How much you love me. Etc. Etc. Take care of yourselves. And yeah, this week I'm going to try vlog something. Gizuzama. Yantembisa. And also follow me on Instagram. I'm at Mpoabadimu. I have a broadcast channel there called Lozi Hands Worldwide. And when I'm not here, that's where I'm at most of the time. So it's very active. So just go in and join the broadcast channel. It's very nice. The other day was Kunwange Nefu, and it's just a nice, refreshing thing. And yeah, man. Other than that, do you? Isangoma masibabe. At the end of the day, we're done looking crusty and stuff. Love yourself. Be sexy. Be scrumptious. I was wearing tani dozu ulenga ulengisaini uanengezela. You are fresh, you are happening, you are damn guys, I need to, it's so hard, I can't even steam with lashes on, so I need to wait for them to fall off. But ngafaka ama goggles, you know, those steaming goggles, and then steam, because I mean what you know what was. So anyway, from me, Mpo Wabadimu, the advocate of Idlozi, this was another insightful video. It was a sit-down, actually, not even a story time. I think we need to do story time. Also, if you want me as to carry on with story time, please make sure that you invest in the channel. So invest in the channel, and you can, you know, do you want us to continue from where I left off, that chapter Smang Mang? Because if you want us to do that, I can even do that even tomorrow. Then we can do chapter what. Because you can imagine since that video, a lot of things have happened. But yeah, so yeah, we'll see what happens. Yeah, so anyway, I love you guys. Take care of yourself. To the gents in this channel, I see you and I love you and I appreciate you. You are the pillars of this channel, and to the glossy hands that are forever liking my videos and enjoying me in the company of their homes, or rather in the spaces of their homes, thank you so much for watching this video and allowing our energies to exchange, or rather our energy to intertwine within these couple of minutes. I hope everything was worth it and you will take your journey with a pinch of sherbet and salt and stop taking life too seriously. Life is for the living. Do not exist. Live. Your gift should not be a prison. I am poverty with the advocate of Idlozi. Ugogo unkomiyahlala isangoma sibabayo ngitsigini thokoza store.